Okay, so, I don't know if you guys heard this in Michigan State. We're going to Maryland, West Virginia, Cal Poly, or Iowa. And so, for the past 6 years of my life, I've been trying to beat the Hawkeyes. And so, the last 4 years, not so much, because they've been trying to beat us. We won the Nationals 4 years in a row. So, but they're really good on the top. Okay, this is right here where Iowa beats a lot of teams. Okay, get your butt down here. Yeah, face that way. Don't worry about the lines yet. So when he gets on the mat, we're going to talk about your stance and stuff, but what Iowa does really, really well is this right here. They switch to the same leg and then they get their weight on you here. They start busting your flat, keeping your butt that way. Okay, what you're going to do is you're going to stand up, get your feet, you're going to keep that ankle, and as soon as you turn in, power double, smash over your gut. You're tired, you're off the mat, you're back down, now you look bad. Okay? They're giving me a wide berth today. See, it's very good. Smart boys. So, let's think about it like this, alright? When you get set on bottom, which you just did, which your shoestrings are down, right? You're comfortable right here. That's cool. But think about it like this, alright? When you're resting on your feet, is your weight on your shoestrings? It's not really possible, anatomically speaking, right? I mean, no, that can't work unless you're tying your shoe on bottom. Where's your weight? Yeah, it balls your feet, or another word would be toes. Yeah, okay, so we want our weight on our toes, okay? We want to be on our toes, balls our feet, really. Able to move, heads up, back straight, right? Elbows are in. This is a good position. So on the mat, we don't really want to be on our shoestrings either, okay? I learned it like this, and we did this all straight through St. John's. Here, because why? We want to get up the ankle kick, correct? Well, let me tell you this, all right? Come out here and get set here. If I want that ankle, that's not stopping me from getting it. And the way I'm going to do that is to be on top of this, keep your shoes down. So just like that. Thanks. Okay, got it. Didn't really help that much there, did it? Specifically, I'll karate chop his thigh, my knee will ram straight up his butt, and bam, look, his ankle just came right up. Even if somehow he's strong enough to stay in that position right there, first of all, I'm sorry, I'm Hercules, so he's not going to be. But if he was, and I started to knee him here, and he just went that far, I can still pick his ankle up, it's coming up. You see that? So if I want that ankle, and his laces are down, I can still get it. Jam, catch, look, it comes up every time. Okay, go back and sit down a little. So I don't care about that. If you're more comfortable doing that, great. As I've gotten older, and not just older, but smarter, I'm pretty explosive from here. Okay, if my toes curl, it's your decision, however you want to get set, okay? Like I said, I'm older, so I do things a little differently these days than I did when I was in high school. Do what you feel is best. Things that I do have to have you do, not this. Okay, when my elbows go out, you're beat. Instantly, you're not going to be able to get it anywhere. Okay, so I don't want my elbows out like this. You guys ever watch NCAA wrestling? You know who Jesse Delgado is? Mm-hmm. That dude gets in here and he gets like this, that's illegal. Okay, but they let him get away with it every time, so it's not illegal. He gets down set, and his arms are right on his legs, and you can't get underneath him.
Where is he from, Coach?
Illinois. Okay. Yeah, University of Illinois. Is that where you're from? That's cool. Boris Boshkov's training there, too. He's a good guy. My friend, Wim Mahalik. Wins stud. Well, anyway, Jesse's really good. He beat our guy Nico a couple times. Nico beat him several times, but Jesse's two-time national champ. That's enough right there, okay? So what we're doing is we're bending our elbows in to close this distance down right there. I'm kind of cranking my thumbs forward a little bit right here because that gives me some shock absorption. So if you try to chop me, the worst thing that's going to happen is going to hit my elbow. I'm not going to collapse. And he's not taking this across me. So if he chops me, I can just buckle to an elbow. All right? Same thing, heads up. When I was a little bit younger, Coach, I used to be like, get your back all explosive. That's not necessary. As long as it's straight, you're feeling good right here. So my elbows are in. Okay, the weight on my hand is basically on the butt of my hand, like the heel of my hand right here. You understand? Because I want to explode. And I can't be covering my feet. Okay, I can't be sitting just back. You're not going anywhere here but down your face. So you want to be off your haunches a little bit, okay? Because I'm ready to explode, so my muscles got to be getting a little bit of blood to them, so I want to be up a little. I want to be able to explode, but I want to be covering my feet. So this is the position I want you guys to all go out and get set in and just get comfortable here for a little bit, okay? We're going to do it a couple times. Just go and find a good, comfortable bottom position.
Coach, how much weight on your hands?
Not much. I want none, really. But, you know, they're not going to let you just go out there and be like, hey, okay. They won't let you get away with that, okay? You can cheat some things in college. Like I said, Jesse does that real well. Another thing that we do with cheating in college is when the ref gets set up out there, we just get our knee right up in him, touch him, our back leg. They hardly ever call that. They don't care. They want the bottom guy set. It's his responsibility to start moving. In high school, it's a lot different than that. Top guy has to show some action. Or they're going to start nailing the top guy. It's one of the things that I have trouble with in high school. Specifically in the state of Ohio, it's just they don't let the top guy rest. And so when you get to college, it takes time for you guys to get adjusted to that, okay? They're going to hit the bottom dude in college every time. So we got to get ready right away. And this is where I like to get. I like to get a little bit lower stance, like I said. My weight's off my hands a little bit. My thumbs are forward already a little bit. Not like this, but just a little bit, you know? I mean, I can point my thumbs forward and keep my hands 10 to 2, right? That's if you guys take driver's ed. 10 to 2, 10 to 2. Okay, well, yeah, that's where I kind of want to point. Don't drive like that. Really? But in wrestling, get there. Okay? I got good shocks, and I'm off my haunches. I'm ready to explode here, okay? I want you to go out there about 2 minutes and just get out of your thing and get comfortable back in there, okay? Get out of your stance, turn a little bit. Okay? And just get comfortable. But I don't want you on your heels, all right? However you want your feet. If you want your toes down, I don't care, but make sure you're still not sitting back, okay? Ready to explode. You got it? You got it? You got any questions? Does anybody else have any questions? You can come, Sean, dude. It's cool. Sean. Coach. Sean. That's Coach. Sean. Ready?
Yeah.
All right, on two. Let's go get set. Ready? 1, 2.